More on growing calls to restrict the unprecedented migration flowing into Europe and beyond, we turn to former British Foreign Secretary David Miliband, who is now president and CEO of the International Rescue Committee, and András Simonyi. He was Hungary's ambassador to the United States and is now professor at the School of Advanced International Studies at Johns Hopkins University. Gentlemen, welcome. Mr. Miliband, have the attacks in Paris and Beirut changed everything?
I think that they have brought a new level of urgency and clarity to the challenges facing not just Western politicians, but actually politicians around the globe. The European refugee crisis has crept up on the European Union over the last 3 or 4 years when its attention was focused on the euro crisis and on the Russian intervention in Ukraine. The refugee crisis is now center stage, and it's center stage for all the wrong reasons, and not just the horrific bombings in Beirut, the appalling attacks in France, but obviously the ongoing tragedy inside Syria itself. I think the important thing is that they change some things. The appalling attacks do need to bring a new level of rigor, clarity, and consistency to the way in which the political settlement is sought in Syria. They do need to bring a new level of humanity to the very, very difficult situation that's faced by refugees in the neighboring states, 4 or 5 million of them. And of course, they need to bring increased coordination on the security front across Europe and with US partners, although it has to be said that the US situation is dramatically different from that in Europe.
Well, and we'll get to that. Ambassador Simonyi, Hungary has taken a hard line on this idea of migration. And I wonder whether you see any connection between that debate and the debate we have seen about who is behind these bombings in Paris especially.
Well, of course, these issues are connected. There are three things that are kind of piling on each other. One is the refugee crisis. The second is ISIS. And the third is homegrown terrorism. And these three things are a very, very dangerous mix, a very explosive mix. I do not agree with the Hungarian government's line that a total isolation, building a barbed wire around Hungary, not letting in any refugees without discrimination, is going to do the trick. But one thing, let me get back to the question that you asked, Mr. Miliband. I do think it has changed something. There is now a greater sense of urgency in Europe to figure this out and figure it out together.
Well, is urgency a good thing, Mr. Miliband, or is it conflation of unrelated events?
Well, the danger of urgency, obviously, is that it leads to panic. The issue of the fake, now clearly fake, Syrian passport that became a story over the weekend. I'm afraid it's a sad truth that the lie is halfway around the world before the truth gets its boots on. And I think that the ambassador is right to say that there is real urgency now about three things. First of all, the issue of how Europe is going to support the neighboring states of Syria in coping with the refugee load. Secondly, how Europe is going to process the 500,000, 600,000, even 700,000 refugees who've arrived in Europe over the last year or so, many of them now in Germany, most of them now in Germany. And thirdly, obviously, the acute security challenge relating to the new evidence that ISIS is willing to strike outside the Middle East. Until now, the consensus opinion among academics has been that ISIS was focused on building the so-called caliphate within the Middle East. Now it's clear that ISIS is ready to strike beyond those boundaries, and that puts an absolute premium on the security effort in respect of the homegrown problem that the ambassador has put his finger on.
But, Mr. Ambassador, I wonder if you, I want to ask you about the conflation question and the dangers of that. Obviously, urgency when there's a crisis is not necessarily a bad thing. But what should be done? And should it be the EU? Should it be the UN? Should it be Vienna?
Well, when I say urgency, definitely no panic. There are things we have to do immediately, and then there are things we have to fix long term. Interestingly enough, yesterday I came across an interview that was a report that was done about Molenbeek, the place where the terrorists came from in Brussels. 87 That is almost 30 years ago, which suggests that if they don't give these people a chance to integrate into society, if they don't give them jobs, if they don't give them opportunities, this is going to be an explosive, and we will pay a huge price. Now, there is some introspection that we have to go through, but I truly believe that. You know, I believe that if Europe can get out of this, I call it a mess, it will get out of it stronger. Disintegrating and weakening the European Union is not a response. Let me also add that I truly believe this has to be a transatlantic issue, and the United States and Europe needs to cooperate very, very closely to find a way out of this.
Well, David Miliband, as I'm sure you're keeping track of, there has been the mild way of saying it is reluctance. The harsher way is saying backlash in the United States to the idea of accepting additional refugees. Is freedom compatible with security in moments like this?
I think not only is freedom compatible with security, but effective refugee resettlement is founded on effective security. The U.S. has a really excellent record in maintaining the security vetting process in respect of refugees. The extensive nature of the security vetting process is one of the explanations for the fact that only 2,200 Syrians have been allowed into this country over the last 4 years. It's a very, very rigorous security vetting process. And one of the dangers of the current debate in the U.S. is that the facts get lost. And the facts are that 12 to 15 U.S. government agencies, including the intelligence agencies, spend 18 to 24 months vetting all the refugees who are put forward for resettlement into the U.S. And I think it's very important to maintain the principle that refugee resettlement is an American success story that should be built on. It's certainly not something that should be ripped up.
Mr. Simonyi, Ambassador, is there any such thing as enough vetting in cases like this?
Don't count on 100% foolproof vetting. That's not going to work. But I do believe, and I totally agree with Mr. Miliband, that if we allow these events to result in us giving up our ideals, our principles, which includes, of course, welcoming refugees who are really, really in trouble, running from war zones, then we are giving up more than the refugees. Then we're giving up what our societies are supposed to be about.
David Miliband, President and CEO of the International Rescue Committee, and András Simonyi, the former ambassador to the U.S. from Hungary. Thank you both very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.